All right, guys, we're here. Second segment now. Here we go. I'm going to play. They're going to show the playbook of our defense first and then our offense second. Here we go. This is the book. Let me see if I can play it.
Welcome to ButchLatus.com. Today we will look at the flip side of the University of Miami. We will look at their defense.
Yeah, don't look at our defense. This Butch.
Great players, great defensive linemen, outstanding secondary. You've got a tremendous amount of interceptions. We're going to see how those two feed off of each other as we take a look at the challenge that we've got this Saturday against Miami's defense. Now let's take a look at the University of Miami's defense, and clearly one of the strengths of their defense is their defensive line, the ability to put pressure on the quarterback. They've got outstanding pass rushers, and the pressure on the quarterback.
This was the FSU game they're showing here, guys.
Here you see Christian Ponder of Florida State throwing the ball down the middle of the field, and Von Telemach, the free safety, does a great job of covering the outside half of the field, making sure that there's no threat, and then he overlaps the intended receiver down the middle of the field, makes a great play on the football.
That was the interception by Ponder there.
It's a terrific play
by VT.
It's an outstanding job of their secondary. All these things go hand in hand. When you're getting ready to play a team like the University of Miami, you've got to be concerned about the blitzes and the line stunts and the games, the people coming off the perimeter, but you also got to be aware of exactly where those defenders are in the secondary.
And that's the thing you have to remember, guys. You know, we will throw some packages at Carolina in this game that maybe that isn't so. Now, let's see if I could get the Butch Davis press conference here, so...
Just a little bit of a
look. Here's Butch, guys.
Saturday's game at Virginia, and just after we looked at the film, certainly some of the important parts of winning that ball game were the creation of the turnovers defensively. Anytime you get near the beneficiary of five interceptions, certainly a couple of them were at or near the red zone or close to it, and that was, very, very critical in keeping them out of the end zone. I think that and the explosive plays that we were able to generate offensively were a big part of the success. So we got a lot of big plays. Great way to start the game. Dwight's catch, the first play, goes the length of the field for a touchdown on what we were hoping to bring up second down and five. We just were trying to get a quick throw underneath and turned into a touchdown. There's good things that happened, things that certainly our kids will learn from and will get better. Another area, though, that we did kind of take some steps backwards in was in special teams. And as we move forward and get ready to start talking about Miami with the explosiveness of their returners, we have got to do a much, much better job of kicking the football. I think it starts there, the actual kicking of the football, both on kickoffs and on punts. Really puts your coverage units in behind the eight ball, so to speak, because of the hang time, the direction of the kick, how long it stays in the air, giving the guys that are going down there the best opportunity. And certainly Casey regrets he tried to overkick in an attempt to try to get more distance and kick two of them out of bounds. And it seemed like after every kickoff, we spotted them field position where they were starting at or near about midfield just about every time. So we've definitely got to do a much better job on that part. Defensively, it was good to get Lin-Juan Yule back a little bit to play. He had a little bit of depth to the defensive end to be able to try to rotate some guys and get some guys an opportunity to catch their breath and come over to the sidelines. And so it was good to have him back. It was kind of an unexpected pleasure. We didn't really know it was going to transpire. And so it was easier to kind of plug him in just from the standpoint that we knew he could do because of having been here for 4 years, that he could go in and in a limited role do some of the things. He didn't have a total grasp of the entire, game plan that we'd put in for the entire thing. So hopefully with a week's worth of work, we'll be able to get a little bit more maybe out of him in the next couple of weeks. I think it's important for our football team. I told them yesterday that we've really got to emphasize some of the fundamentals, making sure that we tackle better than we tackled a little bit, minimize some of the run after catch, and then offensively, we've got to do a much better job. We can't against really, really good football teams, you can't have big plays taken away. We had a touchdown taken off the board with a holding call and some of those kinds of things. So hopefully we'll try to continue to impress upon that. The team we're playing this week, I think you know, without any stretch of the imagination at all, it is clearly the most physically gifted football team, and they are playing extremely well. They've played maybe one of the tougher schedules of anybody that we've played. I mean, playing Ohio State and Clemson and the teams that they've been having to play against, Florida State, you know, several of them are ranked teams, and they've played well. They've beat some of them, but they are a good, good football team, and they've got an awful lot of talent and depth on the defensive side of the ball. They've got explosive big-time playmakers at wide receiver and running back position. Quarterback is, yeah, I mean, he is scary. I mean, he's as good a quarterback as there is. He can throw the ball extremely well. He's so athletic that he's hard to contain and keep him in the pocket. And it'll be as big a challenge as we've had this entire season. No update as of right now. I mean, he still has, you know, remaining issue, and we'll try to get some kind of closure as soon as possible.
Yeah, no.
He has a fractured fibula, and he'll be out for the season.
Any shot?
You know what, Joe? I don't know right now. I mean, they haven't. I don't know how long it takes, you know, bones to mend.
That's when they talk about Penalto being out, and you know. Penalto being out, and that's going to hurt them in their tight end. That's the thing that's hurt us over the years. So I'm going to see if I can play it a little bit more.
To you, instead of you seeking out big plays and just, you know, he's being smart with the ball. I think we've had some improvement in the offensive line. That certainly all quarterbacks, you know, certainly relish the idea that the offensive line's got a little bit more savvy. They're able to protect a little better. We've been able to run the ball, you know, in most games, you know, some effectiveness, and I think everybody recognizes how important that is to a quarterback, that if you just literally can't run the ball at all, I mean, if you're just totally stone shut out and you've got to throw the ball 45, 50, 55 times, you know, that's a bad way to have to operate as a quarterback. But TJ's, I think he's just playing with a lot of good maturity.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that we're going to be taking a look at, you know, during the course of the week. I think he's, again, it'll be, yeah, same deal with all these guys. I mean, we'll have a better idea after they get a couple of days of treatment. Yeah. You know, I think, you know, clearly, you know, Kevin and Michael, for those of you that aren't aware, they were, their apartment burned down this summer. And, you know, I guess if you can look at it, what a horrible, tragic deal that it was, and they lost a lot of personal effects and a lot of things that certainly meant an awful lot to them. The good news is they saved their lives. It didn't happen at night while they were asleep, and, you know, you could imagine what potentially could have happened if it's not the middle of the afternoon, and you know, so it's good. I mean, Kevin's a pretty smart kid, and, you know, I would put him in that same category in some respects as we talked about Kareem and Tim Jackson a while ago, that when he came in here, he was a little bit untypical.
And the thing you get with that is, and I get...
Was there pressure for him to kind of
move up? No, I think it's significantly easier, you know, in my experiences with guys like Dan Morgan and some of the guys, DJ Williams, a lot of times when you're interjecting a new younger player, Jonathan Vilma is a little bit like that. And you go in there and you've got a Dan Morgan there beside you. You've got somebody else that's got experience. And I think all of our linebackers have benefited from the presence of Bruce Carter and Quan Sturdivant, that they're smart football players, they're good kids, they work hard,
Well, he mentions two things. Bruce Carter, who, by the way, is a Buckets Award semifinalist, and Quan Sturdivant. And you were going to see them in this game. Let's make no mistake about it. We are going to have to be aware where he is, because Bruce Carter turned the Rutgers game around. And if our line does not protect Ja'Cory, what happened to Rutgers quarterback Savage and Dodd, their backup, could happen to Ja'Cory in this game. We have got to protect Ja'Cory at all costs in this ballgame. So I was going to do two seconds. Actually, I'm going to do one more, and I'm going to try to get Randy Shannon in, and I will give you my prediction for tomorrow night's game. So I'll be back in the final segment. Right back.